In this video, we will see how to install Git on Windows 11. Let us see. At first, open the web browser. On Google, type Git and press enter. On pressing enter, the official website is visible, git-scm. Click on it. Now here is the official website. When you'll go below, the current version is visible. Download for Windows. Click download for Windows. Now when you'll reach here, directly the current version will be visible here. Click here to download. I'll click on it. Now the download started. Let's wait. Right click the exe file and click open. Minimize. This is the license. Click next. Now this is the location where Git will get installed. Keep it as it is and it will take 344 MB only. Click next. Now here select components option is visible. Okay, I'll click on additional icons. I have clicked additional icons and click next. It will create a start menu folder, not a problem. Click next. Now you need to choose the default editor used by Git. Okay, here select any of them. Let's say I'll select, so I selected VS Code as Git's default editor. You can select any of them. Now click next. Here you need to decide the name of the initial branch. Okay, I'll go for the second one. So I click down override the default branch name for new repositories and I'll click next. Now you need to adjust your path environment. Here recommended is visible. So keep the default, that is Git from the command line. Click next. Choosing the SSH executable. Here you need to select which secure shell client you want the Git to use. So I'll keep the bundled OpenSSH as it is and click next. Now you need to choose the HTTPS transport backend. So this will validate the server certificates with the .crt file. So I'll keep the default. Use the OpenSSL library and click next. Configuring the line ending conversions. Okay, since we are installing on Windows, so I'll keep the default, check out Windows style and click next. Here you need to configure the terminal emulator to use with Git bash. Here I'll keep the default, that is the default terminal, and click next. Now you need to select the default behavior of Git pull. I'll keep it as fast, forward or merge. Click next. Choose a credential help. I'll keep it as Git credential manager only and click next. Enable file system caching. I'll keep it the default, that is enable file system caching, and click install. Guys, we have installed Git. We can directly click here to launch Git bash. And it also created a desktop shortcut. I'll click finish. Now go to start. Type cmd, click open. Now let us type git here and press enter. Okay, this shows that we successfully installed it. Okay, for free tutorials, refer the link in the description of this video. Guys, if you like the video, you can directly go to our channel and support us by subscribing and joining. Click on the join button. Herein you can support us. Okay, by clicking join here. And you can also go to any of our video. Okay, herein click on the three dots and click thanks. You can also directly support us here. Okay. Thank you for watching.